I'm fusing together my 3D printed C3PO using plastic welding. I got this plastic welding machine not too long ago, and for my first project tried it out on C3PO's chest. I shared that on TikTok and got a ton of great tips and tricks and feedback. So, based off of what I learned, we're gonna go again and work on his shorts. I'll be using the Altern plastic welder that I got off of Amazon. And the first piece I'm using it on is printed with 3D Print Life's PETG. But I'll also be showing you using it on PLA Plus. Typically, I plastic weld using a soldering iron and scrap filament. And that's worked with any filament I've tried it on. I only mention the materials here, because for each I'm going to be heating up the machine for just a little bit different times. We're going to start with the edges and use this metal staple. I'm going to knock out this one really quick and show you a close-up for a better example. For the rest of the line, we're going to use a squiggly staple. To heat it up, I'll hold the trigger for 2 seconds, and then place it into the 3D print, making a slight 15-degree turn after I'd melted through several layers. Then I wait a few seconds till it hardens a little, and detach the staple from the machine. And I'm going to repeat this process as many times as it takes to go down the length of the seam. Removing the prongs is actually super easy. All you gotta do is bend it in on itself, and boom, no prongs. They break off right below the weld line, which is amazing. Our next piece is also part of the shorts, and is printed with Polymaker PolyTerra PLA Plus. The biggest difference on how we're gonna do this one is our timing is gonna be a little bit less on how long we heat it up for. So instead of counting to 2 seconds, we're just gonna do 1 to 1.5. This hold was about 15 seconds to give it enough time to harden. And then wiggled it free. Starting with the edges was a great way to get alignment for all of the pieces. And after those two initial ones were in, it was very easy to get the rest knocked out. The most time-consuming part was waiting for the plastic to cool down before moving the staple from the welder. For C3PO shorts, we got the rest of the plastic welding done and then broke off all the prongs. And then I switched out the tip on the plastic welder for the flat melting tip. We're gonna use some scrap filament and melt it into our weld lines to make sure that there's no leaks. Just like with C3PO's chest, after I'm done with all the plastic welding and everything's put together, I'm gonna reinforce the print using liquid plastic. For C3PO's chest, I did 2 coats and it reinforced it really nicely. Now back to finishing up our plastic welding. Same as before, we're gonna pull that trigger, except this time we're gonna hold it a bit longer and melt the filament as needed. This one was a little different and I can't give you a clear timer and I just did it by feel. I'd say just be mindful as you're working and shift your timing accordingly. Not only is this going to help us reinforce this piece and help prevent leaks with the liquid plastic, but it's also a great way to recycle the supports that I used to print this piece, which is typically one of my favorite reasons of choosing plastic welding as a means to connect my pieces. I do like recycling material when possible. So when all is said and done, none of these will be visible and we won't have any weld lines on the front. We will have some slight gaps on the front that we will be filling in with Liquitex modeling paste, just like we did with C3PO's chest. The rest of his body is not that far behind, we'll get there. My hope is that this will be helpful for your 3D printing journey as well. If you have any questions about this process, please don't hesitate to ask in the comments. And if you want to be part of this journey of seeing C3PO come to life, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching!